Hello there. Let's see in this video the most important features of Shotcut, one of the best open source video editors for everyone that wants to create and edit a video in the simplest way and in the shortest time. This is completely free to use and gets updated monthly on all the major operating systems, such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. Do not forget to visit our YouTube channel and our website to get extra content and free tips for other outstanding software. When opening Shotcut, its main interface opens, showing quick options to either start with a new project or pick a recent project on the right, all saved in .mlt files. To start a new project, just specify its destination folder, its name, and its resolution and frame rate on video mode, including 4K with 60 frames per second. When clicking on Start, the project is created completely empty with no files on it. You can import images, sound files, and videos up to 4K resolution by dragging and dropping these inside the playlist panel on the left. All files are listed with their thumbnail, name, and duration. The main interface is made by several panels you can undock, move around, dock, and close with their cross button. You can reopen these by clicking on the panels on top. The Shotcut workflow is very simple. The playlist panel on the left collects all the media files. The timeline at the bottom is the place where you place and edit your media files to build your own video. And the preview shows the result of the work in progress made on the timeline. Let's see how to create a simple video. All the media files imported on the timeline are shown as blocks called shots, spreading through the time and collected within rows called tracks. By default, a single video track is created, but you can add others by right-clicking and going to Add Video or Audio Track. If the timeline is too small, you can extend it by dragging from its top edge. Video tracks collect images and also video frames within audio, whereas audio tracks contain just sound or audio from videos without any visual content. Each shot shows useful thumbnails on images and video frames and sound waveforms throughout time for the audio part. You can zoom in and out on these with your mouse wheel while holding down the control or command key. The preview on top shows any media content in two ways. With source, you can play back the media content from the playlist panel, whereas with project, you can check the video in progress on the timeline, where its marker is placed in time. You can move it where you like, and also use the left and right arrow keys to move frame by frame. On each track, you can use the mute button to mute its audio content and hide to disable its visual content if you need. Besides the main preview, Shotcut also includes several powerful scopes. With the peak meter, you can check the volume level in time, showing any excessive loudness in red color. The other scopes can be found under View, Scopes, and allow to check the audio spectrum or the video RGB channels during time. Now let's see how to edit on the timeline. Drag any shot to move it in time, within the same track or in another one. If any video is moved on an audio track, only its audio part will be used. Moreover, if you overlap shots within the same track, a crossfade transition is created, which softly moves from the first shot to the second one in transparency. You can right-click on it and go to Properties to edit its kind and options for both the visual and the audio part. To to begin or end with a single shot, you can add fade transitions by dragging from its top corners. This gradually changes the opacity and the volume level of the shot, as much slow as the transition width is. Whereas to change the extension of any shot, just click and drag it from its edges. This cuts part of the original content in the case of videos and audio files. To block any modification on the shots within a track, just enable its lock button. When clicking on any shot, this gets selected in red color, showing all its options on the Properties panel. Here, adjust its aspect ratio, its audio sync, or its metadata. Use speed above to change the speed rate of the shot in order to stretch or shorten it without affecting its original content. You can cut, copy, and paste any selected shot with Control or Command on Mac and X, C, and V. You can also split any shot in two by placing the main marker on it and using Split at Playhead. To remove any shot, select it and use the Backspace key. If you make any mistake, use the Undo and Redo buttons on the top or the History panel on the right. Shotcut includes loads of professional effects inside the Filters panel. Select the shot interested and use the plus button to browse inside the effects list. Under Video, you find filters to apply basic editing on the shot, such as rotate and scale, and size and position, to rotate, scale, and move it on the preview. Other effects are dedicated to color correction and enhancement, such as hue lightness, saturation, for light and color intensity, contrast, to adjust contrast, and levels, to set blacks and gamma. For advanced color corrections, you can add white balance to correct the temperature and color grading to adjust the RGB colors and brightness levels on the shadows, the midtones, and the highlights of the shot. Besides these adjustments, you can also apply special effects such as blur, chrome key, glow, mosaic, vertigo, and lens correction to correct lenses distortion if present. With the Filters panel, you can also add 2D and 3D pieces of text, typing inside, and setting color, size, extrusion depth, and rotation. In case of 2D text, you can also place and size it directly on the preview. Under Audio, you can balance the stereo channels, correct the audio volume, and apply several audio filters, such as low pass, high pass, band pass, and notch. Correct audio loudness with limiter, compressor, and expander, and apply special audio delays with delay and reverb. All the effects applied get listed above in order and can be turned on and off with their check mark on the left. When selecting any effect, you can edit its properties at the bottom or remove it definitely with the minus button. On most of the effect properties, you can also enable keyframing to change these during time. When turning on the watch button, the keyframes panel opens at the bottom, showing the envelope for all the properties getting keyframes. These are rhombus markers, placed in time, saving a defined property level, so that by applying several markers throughout time, the property level changes by following the envelope created. These filters are independent between one filter and another. When your video is ready, you can render and export it by using the Export panel. Choose any ready template you like on the left and go to Advanced to check or edit the video properties in resolution, aspect ratio, frame rate, codecs, and audio sample rate if you need. Thanks for watching this video. Please visit our YouTube channel to get extra content and other outstanding and free tutorials.